Hi, this is the question 6b. A transmission line in which no distortion is present has the following parameters: Z0 is equal to 60 ohms, alpha is equal to 20 milli Napiers per meter, velocity is equal to 0.7 V0. Determine R, L, G and C and wavelength at 0.1 GHz. This question is given for 7 marks, set number 1, April 2019. First, let us draw the equivalent circuit of the transmission line. The equivalent circuit of the transmission line is simple: R, L, G, and C. So these are called as the primary constants of the transmission line. R, L, G, and C are called as the primary constants of the transmission line. So this is the equivalent circuit per unit length of the transmission line. So for distortionless transmission line, the simple condition is a transmission line is said to be distortionless if simply place a line like this and R by L is equal to G by C condition. For distortionless line, since the line is given distortionless line, the condition is R by L is equal to G by C. Use this condition. From this condition, already we have derived distortionless line conditions. Alpha will come out as root RG. So it is independent. Alpha is independent of frequency, and beta it will come out as omega root LC. Now the characteristic impedance, it is come out as square root of R by G, so that is equal to square root of L upon C. Finally, the velocity is equal to omega by beta. From this relation, omega by beta, so what is the relation? 1 by root LC. We use these relations this relation and this relation to get R and G. Use this relation and Z0 is equal to square root of L by C, these relations to get L and C. Now let us first multiply R, alpha and Z0 to get R and alpha by Z0 to get G. So first to multiply alpha into z0, you will get R. So from which the series resistance R is equal to, what is alpha is given? Alpha is given as 20 milli. 20 milli means 20 into 10 power minus 3 into characteristic impedance of the line is 60 ohms. It will come out as alpha 1.2 ohms per meter. So this is the value of series resistance, 1.2 ohms per meter. Simple answer. Now the next step is divide alpha by z0 to get G. So therefore alpha by z0, it will come out as G. So from which G is equal to alpha. Alpha is given as 20 millihenry, 20 into 10 power minus 3 by the characteristic impedance of the line is 60. So from which it will come out as 0.333 milli MHO per meter. So this is the value of G. So therefore the value of G is the shunt conductance. It is called a shunt conduction, 0.333 milli inverse ohm per meter. So this is the shunt conductance. Now use the relation Z0 is equal to root L by C and velocity is equal to 1 by root LC formulas to get L and C. But velocity is given in this problem, velocity is given as 0.7 into V0, where V0 is the velocity of light. So that is 0.3 into, what is the velocity of light? 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. So that is equal to 2.1 into 10 power 8 meters per second. So this is the velocity nowadays. Now multiply V into Z0
that is Z naught into V. So to get what is Z naught? Root L by C into what is V? 1 by root L C. Root L gets cancelled, so it will come out as 1 by C. So therefore C is written as 1 by Z naught into U or V, velocity of light. That is 1 by, so what is characteristic impedance of the line? 60 ohms into velocity with which the wave is propagating, 2.1 into 10 power 8 meters per second, from which the capacitance will come out as 79.37 picofarads per meter. So this is the answer for the capacitance. This is the answer for capacitance. Now, next one, divide Z by Z naught by U, velocity. Z naught is square root of L by C, and 1 by V naught is root L C. So you will get root C gets cancelled out, you will get L. So therefore what is L is written as Z naught by velocity. What is Z naught is given? 60 ohms. By what is the velocity you get? 2.1 into 10 power 8 meters per second. From which the inductance per unit length, it will come out as 285.71 nano Henry per meter. So this is the answer for L. Answer for L. Finally, the velocity is given as F lambda, V is equal to F lambda, from which the wavelength is asked. The wavelength is V by F. So what is V with which the wave is traveling on 2.1 into 10 power 8 meters per second by. So what is the frequency is given as 0.1 into giga is 10 power 9, from which the wavelength lambda will come out as 2.1 meters. So this is the answer for this problem to get 7 marks. Thank you.